All right, so we are trying out the new camera. There's a lot. Like, I have a couch now. So, that's cool, I guess. But there's still a lot that I have to rearrange to get this into a more workable space. Because, like, the couch is cool, but it kind of disrupted my whole ecosystem here. So we have to figure something out, for sure. What about, okay, so that's it, kind of. Why isn't that displaying? This is a little setup. I'll get it better in a second. Sorry, I meant to film that entire process, but the store closed in like 10 minutes and I wanted to get that shipped out today. What am I shipping? You may have noticed I am returning my Ronin M. I had it for like a couple days. It just wasn't working. That's like one of the big issues that I had with the Ronin M is that it just didn't work. The batteries didn't charge. I couldn't get it connected to my phone at all. It was like stuck in a mode, like I can't control it. I tried ordering the like controller piece to it and it hasn't come yet. It got lost in shipping, and if the camera gets stuck like at an angle, then it's just stuck. There's nothing I can do unless I bring out the gigantic controller, and it's not really something that I wanted to deal with. I don't know, it just, like, there was nothing, like, things just weren't working out. So, I think, instead, I'm looking at either getting the Ronin S, because right now I have the SC, and the S would be very familiar, or maybe the Moza Air 2. Those are the ones that are kind of, like, iffy for me. I'm kind of leaning towards Moza Air. I've already jumped ship from Sony to Panasonic, so I might as well just jump ship again from DJI into Moza. That one seems like it's pretty nice. I don't know. I have to watch some videos about that. But that's not even what we're talking about today. I mean, it kind of is. What we are talking about today is my very first impressions of the S1H. So I haven't really used the camera. Like use. I haven't filmed anything. In fact, this is my first thing that I'm filming with this camera. So let me know if it looks good or not, because I hope it does, because this camera costs way too much for it to not look good. So do you see any improvement at all?
What about now? Maybe. Does this look better? Does the audio sound? Oh, hold up. Let me. Okay, so maybe the audio's not clipping anymore. Oh wait, how about now? It looks like it has my face. Does this look 6K? What if I add some lights and stuff? Is that better? I really can't tell. Wait, let it, hello? Are we focused now? This is literally like the first time that I'm filming with this camera. And yes, I know that there's this thing in front of my face. I guess now that we have the close-up, I can get rid of that. Now it's just me. Is this better? Someone please tell me. We are filming in 6K. This is the first time that I've really used this camera. So let's talk about this, you know? Let's talk about the camera. If we're gonna talk about it, I might as well just grab it. Let me, So here we are. This is the Panasonic S1H. Can you see it at all? Or is it just too dark? This thing is supposedly a beast, and that is what we're going to be figuring out, hopefully soon. Again, I haven't really done anything with this, but I picked up the S1H, the Sigma 50mm 1.4, and the Sigma 24mm 1.4. Look at the beautiful, beautiful, can you see it? This is what we're talking about today. My very first impressions of this camera. All right, so we already talked about the gimbal. The Ronin M, that was my dream gimbal for so long, and I finally got it, and it just didn't work out. And it makes me so sad. It really hurts my heart that the Ronin M didn't work out. I can't tell you how much I have been looking forward to filming with that, and for it to just not work, it just... But we'll discuss that when the new gimbal comes. So, my first impressions of this camera are that it's gigantic. It is a mirrorless camera, but it is the size of a DSLR. It is probably the size of a 5D. It's not quite up there with the 1DX, so I would say that the closest thing is like a 5D. It's gigantic. I thought it was gonna be too big. I was really concerned about like my hand and stuff, like holding this, but you know, luckily that's not the case. It's nice and hefty. I had to go through a couple of settings just to make it a little bit more usable. So one thing that I like absolutely had to change was the live preview. If you go under the settings thing, if you go three down and then over four down, it's under constant preview. If you have to turn that on. If you're taking your photos for whatever reason, if you don't have that on, the camera is gonna show you whatever it is that it wants to show you. You're gonna take a photo and it's gonna look completely different than the image that you're looking at. But once you turn on constant preview, then the image right here on the back of the LCD is going to be the same as the photo that you're actually taking. So that's kind of like a necessity. You kind of need that. That was definitely like one of the things that stumped me for a second. Another thing is just having to deal with full frame. I'm coming from APS-C right now. I'm filming on the Sony a6400. That was my previous camera and I jumped right into this one. So I drastically underestimated the true effect of full frame. I picked up a 50 millimeter and a 24 millimeter, as I said earlier, and that was not it. I should have got a 50 and an 85. I'm thinking that these two lenses are gonna be good enough to start off with, but the next thing that I'm getting for this camera is an 85 millimeter because that is what I am used to as a 50 millimeter. For whatever reason, I just didn't think about it. Right now, I don't have a very good portrait kind of lens. That 85 millimeter is really gonna be like amazing for just about all of the stuff that I wanna do, to be quite honest. That lens is gonna change a lot. It is. It's gonna make me like this camera a whole lot more. The 50 millimeter is all right. That's probably a good like first lens to get. If you are looking at lenses, I would probably suggest in the case that you don't need low light, I picked up prime lenses because I mostly film at night. But if that's not you, I would highly suggest the Sigma 14-24 and then the 24-70. Get those two lenses, you'll be perfectly okay. There are 2.8. You'll be golden. I don't know what else I was saying, but the 50 seemed like a pretty good lens to start off with. I definitely want to get the 85 because that having a full frame is insane. Speaking of full frame, I started off getting the Sigma 18-35. I was unaware that that was actually an APS-C lens. It wasn't a full frame lens. For whatever reason, I thought that was a full frame lens, but again, it's not. So I got that with this camera, and of course, this is a full frame lens, and that lens was not compatible, which means that I didn't get 6K with this camera. So that's the reason I had to get these lenses. So when you're in APS-C mode, you don't get 6K. So that is the super 35 millimeter mode. You don't have access to 6K. So you need a full frame lens in order to get the full capabilities of this camera. What a shocker. So my very first impressions of this camera were getting a lens that just didn't work and getting a gimbal that didn't work. And after I got these lenses, I got an SD card that again just didn't work for this camera. The SD card that I got to start off with was the Lexar 250 megabyte per second SD card. Well, that did not let me film in 6K. The SD card was not fast enough. So instead, can you see that? Still don't know if you can see it or not. I don't think that was worth all of the effort. But what I ended up getting, What I ended up getting was the Lexar 300 megabyte per second SD cards. I got 228 gigs just to be safe. That gives me like an hour of 6K footage or something like that, which isn't bad. My only other option was the Sony Rough SD cards, and those ones are 180 a piece. These ones are like 120-ish a piece. So you can imagine I was gonna save like $120 or something like that by getting these ones, and they have the exact same like specifications. If you look on the SD cards where it says like V90 and like U3 and stuff like that, all of those specs were the exact same. So these ones, like this card, is the same speed. It's just a lower price. So after I finally got an SD card, oh, first off, this card right here, again, you probably can't see it. I don't know. This is the SanDisk Extreme 150 megabyte, 256 gig card. This is the one that I normally use on the Sony a6400. I put that in my car just to take photos with in the meantime while I was waiting for the new SD cards. Well, as it turns out, this SD card, for whatever reason, can film, like, it works with the 6K in this camera. I don't know what it is, but I had it filming in 6K and it never told me that the SD card wasn't fast enough. I don't know what it is about this card. Maybe that's a little hack for this camera. I'm not entirely sure. I can test it out a little bit more as I start using the camera more often. But as of right now, I'm fully convinced that I can use this card and film in 6K, which is insane. But another thing that has been starting to catch my eye about this camera is the autofocus. Apparently, Panasonic doesn't have like the best autofocus in the game. I didn't know that. But if you're coming from a GH5 or something like that, you already know this and you're already familiar. This is like a gigantic boosted GH5. It's like a GH5 crossed with a cinema camera. So you already know that about the autofocus. Apparently it's not the best. I didn't know this. The autofocus is a little interesting to start to get used to. There are so many buttons. You can program every single thing on this camera. There's so many programmable buttons. It's insane. You really don't have to go like into the menu for anything. You can program every single one of these buttons to do anything that you can possibly want. There's a little joystick here on the back, and that is acting as like my focus point. So I kind of like, I can hit this joystick and move my focus around, or I could just touch the screen, because you can actually use the touch screen on here. Coming from Sony, you could really only use the touch screen for like focus reasons. On this, you can actually go through the menu and actually use the touchscreen. So that's nice for once. Yeah, I don't know. I'm really excited. Having a full frame camera is completely different. Everything changes. The photos just have a different feel. That's one thing that I have done with this, is I've gone on a couple photo shoots. I just haven't filmed any video. So you'll really have to let me know what the video stuff looks like, because I'm not entirely sure. But I don't know. This camera is supposed to have the absolute best image quality that you can get. So I am so excited to start using this camera on a whole bunch of shoots. I have a whole bunch of shoots coming up, and this camera is going to be the centerfold of that. So I was going from a mediocre camera, like a a6400. It's pretty mediocre, up into this beast, which is the absolute best. So I am so excited for my image quality to skyrocket through the roof. And I'm interested to see how like editing the footage off of here works, if it really messes with my computer, if I can really, really see a difference between the 6K and the 4K, because we just had like the similar setup going on. So yeah, all of that. I don't know. I'm excited for this camera. Those were some of the things that stuck out to me about this camera just right off of the bat. Again, I'm super excited about it. I'm going to have so many videos. The next video is probably going to be about like what I think about the camera now that I've had it for a week or whatever. So be sure to subscribe. Let me know what content you want to see. Do you want to see anything specific about this camera? I should have a new gimbal coming pretty soon, so we'll get to see all of that. Let me know. Let me know which content you want to see about this camera, because so far there's so much content planned around it. So let me know what you want to see. It sounds like a broken record, but subscribe. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button right now, because I have a whole bunch of content coming out about the camera. But seriously, hit the subscribe button and come back next week as we talk more about this camera, about things that I find out about it, all of the small nitty gritty tips and tricks and all of that goodness. But that should be all for today. So comment down below what kind of content you want to see, any video requests that you got. Subscribe, turn on the bell, come back next week, all of that good stuff. And that is everything. Thank you so much for watching, and yeah. All right. Thank you.